which we took up the example of this one here, this is strength levels, why they are. So that we have seen. How do we, the strength we can associate to the, with the any gate. The syntax is this. This is how we associate any strength level to the gate. So this syntax we have seen last session. And then contention, strength contention, if there is a contention issue, how do we resolve? So the stronger signal will prevail. Based on that, this example one we took last session. So coming to the strength example two here. So what if strength levels are same? Then contention we cannot avoid. So in this example last session we have seen here. Somebody trying to join here. I said to join before time. So again, distraction. So this one. This one, I think, are there any doubts about till here? Last session we have seen. This one contention we are able to resolve. If this is 0, I1, then this is this one. Full 0 is acting here. So if this is I2 is 1, for example, the strength level on this gate G2 is full 1. But whereas full 0, full 1 are of the same level. Strength level is same for them. If you see here, that is the language provided. Strength level is same. Yes. Full 0, full 1 at the same strength level. So, but acting in opposite direction. This is full 1 and this is full 0. So, contention issue. So, this contention issue we can resolve using what is that? Band logic. So, that also we have seen this band. And today you will see this war logic. This is similar to WAND here. I shared this document, I mean this PPT, particular PPT. So I don't know how many of you had been to this topic. So last session till here we have seen this. When 0-1 comes here, this gate, G1. When I1 is 0. So full 0 is actually acting on this G1 net, output net. And when 1 comes, full 1 is acting on G2 net. So, but this O, if you see O, the same net here, G1 is also giving its output on the same net, G2 is also giving output on the same net, but with different strengths here, full 0 and full 1. Whereas full 0, full 1 are of same level. So that's why it's a contention issue here. This X will come here. But this X we are avoiding with the help of this WAND. WAND is a keyword. It's a net data type. This WAND is a type net. So as being said, there are two types of data types in a very large system. So those two types are, one is a net data type, the other is a variable data type. So here in this case, this WAND belongs to net data type. So what it is doing, it is helping us to resolve this contention issue using AND logic. So that's how this one is. Now coming to this one here, this is the same for the WAND example, test bench, it is the test bench here. And this is the example for WAR net. Earlier we have seen WAND. Now this is for the WAR, W-O-R. So a simple thing is, it uses to resolve any contention issue using OR logic. So if you see 0-1, earlier it was resolved using AND logic. So if one net is having 0, the other net is having 1, then the output of the gate will be based on AND logic. So that's why we had there 0 in earlier example. But this time, this is resolved using this WOR, meaning contention issue is resolved using OR logic this time. That's why if 0-1 is coming, output is 1. hope this is clear what this WOR and WAND, these are playing a role, in which way they are playing a role. So these are wired logic, first of all, and these are net data type, and these are supported by the synthesizer tools. Majority of the synthesizers will give us output. Synthesis means if you are using some constructs here, suppose this module to end module, in between you are using some constructs, Verilog keyboards you are using. Constructs means Verilog keyboards you are using. So if those keyboards are not supported by the tool, software tool called synthesizer, then we will not get an output. Netlist we will not get. Netlist will not be generated by the tool. So in a case where netlist will not generated by the tool because of usage of some keywords here, so we call such keywords are unsupported, not supported by the synthesizer, or we call such constructs are non-synthesizable constructs. Non-synthesizable constructs. If constructs, meaning keywords, if keywords are supported by that tool, then such constructs, meaning such keywords, are synthesizable. So you have to ensure yourself that before writing any RTL, you have to consult once the EDA tool document. That document will definitely give you which keywords are supported by that tool and which are not supported. So that's how the point is. So this concept war is clear. So this is about the same one we are opening, guys. Those who are not familiar, carefully see, and if you have any doubts, you please ask. I hope Suresh, can you ensure the screen is visible? Screen is visible, Suresh.
Yes, Jack, it is visible. Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. So here, guys, here we have ISE Design Suite 14.7. It's a integrated software environment design suite 14.7. This is from Xilinx company, guys. So this one is for FPGA only, field programmable gate array. It's a EDA tool for FPGAs. So we have from this same company, some people spell this as a Xilinx, some as a Xilinx, it's a noun. So that depends upon the local, how people are spelling it. But I say that as a Xilinx. So Xilinx is a tool from this, ISE is a tool from the Xilinx. So this company is basically FPGA vendors. They are FPGA vendors. So here, there is another tool called Vivado. This Vivado, but basically Vivado, as I said long ago, I don't know how many of you are able to recollect. One thing is it supports 7 series FPGA tools. So 7 series. And the other thing is we have something called here, suppose if you are writing in C, or C++. So this is high-level language. High-level language is given to something called HLS, High-Level Synthesis Tool. So this HLS tool. So this HLS will convert and it will give us, this is RTL code, RTL code. This RTL code is synthesizable. So this is actually a Verilog code. This is a Verilog code. From whom we got actually, from where we got this? From C to Verilog we got. Who has done this? This HLS has done. This HLS has done. What is HLS? High level synthesis. This is a software. It has done us, it has given us this Verilog code. Now this Verilog code, we can use. One more synthesizer is required. This synthesizer job is to convert this Verilog to gate level netlist. Gate level netlist, nothing but our actual hardware. Remember, this gate level netlist is targeted to particular board here, meaning this, if you are using a vendor, suppose a Xilinx vendor tool, if you are using, so this Xilinx has got several FPGA tools, FPGA hardware kits. So something Artix, some are some Kintex. If you go to the website, you will know with all this listed there, Artix, Kintex, and there is a Vertex. So Vertex, and there is a Spartan. So all these are listed there. If you go to that Xilinx website, you will come to know. So these are seven series, Artix 7, Kintex 7, and among them again different types, radio frequency for applications, different applications. We have different sort of hardware boards. So these hardware boards, here while we are writing this, we chose this RTL to this gate level netlist, RTL to this gate level netlist, this RTL to this gate level netlist, we have to tell here to the tool, that to which among these tools, among these hardware kits, to which kit you want to target this design. You have some design, so some application, design means some application. So suppose say that is that application is a USB application. Somebody was asking in the group USB too, so that's why I picked this one. So USB is a application. Somebody wants to write a USB protocol. They developed a protocol in the C language. So what next? They use this HLS. So this C language, what it does, through this HLS, it converts to RTL. RTL designer, here some fellow will be there. This fellow different, who is developing C, this engineer is different. Another engineer here, he will take this Verilog code, he will use this synthesizer, this synthesizers, RTL to that is gate level at least. This fellow, what he does is, he will obtain this gate level at least. It is his job to pick this target device and ensure that USB protocol is functioning on this target device. So that's how the entire game is. So this Xilinx is a vendor. This vendor, what he will do, he will provide us software as well as kits. Likewise, if you have quarters, I don't know how many of you had been to that Altera website. Now Altera is owned by the Intel, so they have this quarters tool. This is another vendor. This vendor also having similar like tools, HLS tools, some RTL tools, this quarters developers. So the point is, what I'm trying to make with this, the point that I'm trying to make is, this development of HLS is one thing that is different. Development of RTL is secondary thing that is different. These two prime thing that we have to understand. This is something different, this is something different. This is the prime thing. Secondary thing is that, in industry, even today, people are developing this RTL using maybe Verilog HDL or System Verilog or VHDL. Maybe Verilog or another is a VHDL or another is a System Verilog. So either one, people will, even today they are using it, they are developing RTL and they target to some of these designs. This is still happening in the industry. Then what for this HLS? Somebody may question. This answer is, still people, this is under development sort of thing. All applications, that is hardware applications, are not happening directly developing in C and then going to the HLS and then obtaining the Verilog code and then going to the gate level netlist. These things are not yet full-fledgedly happening. 10% these things are not happening. Some 20% maybe this HLS happening, but rest of the thing, RTL development still happening in the company. That is what the current scenario from the company people that I got. So this is the one thing. But the point here is, where I was, for demonstration, those guys who are not familiar, somebody may have doubt that, array, what this fellow is presenting today, he is talking about somebody joining. This point also I want to make it clear. Somebody may think there that these Xilinx or any other, earlier I was talking about Cortex, that is from Intel. So having this one is ISE, the other is having Vivado. Somebody may be thinking, I just want to remove the misconception or misunderstanding. So why he is not taking this advanced one, Vivado, why he is still talking about ISE? So someone may have this sort of feeling. So for them, the answer is, this Vivado is for HLS, one thing that one can practice. The other is you also can develop RTL and still you can perform synthesis. Remember, this HLS is called not synthesis. This is called high level synthesis. So after this step, you get RTL. And then you get gate level netlist. But in this case, second case, what is happening? You don't use HLS. Since you are not using HLS, this one you are not using, you are straight developing RTL. And then you simply perform synthesis, not a high level synthesis. Then you get gate level netlist. So this Vivado will help us to perform this one and also this one. That is the point that one must understand there. If someone having this opinion that why the advanced one he is not demonstrating, why he is demonstrating this. With this one, with ISE, what we can do, we only can write this RTL. We only can write RTL. We cannot write with using ISE, this HLS is not possible. This HLS is not possible using this ISE. That is the another point one must get this. And using advantage of using ISE is this also support other low-end FPGA boards, your Vertex 6, even Spartan 3. Today also this ISE supports Spartan 3E, evolutionary board or training board. So low-end FPGA boards are supported by Xilinx. That is the advantage. Whereas Vivado supports writing RTL, it supports writing RTL, but it is not going to support this low-end FPGAs. It is going to support only 7 series FPGAs. That's the another point that we have to understand. That's the reason why, since our course is not focusing on HLS, our course is focusing on only RTL development using Verilog HDL, for which this ISE is enough. That's why we are not currently focusing on Vivado. Is that clear to everyone there? Yes, Suresh?
Yes, Jack, yes.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you. So that way, that's the reason why we are not currently going to Vivado. In future course of time, if I am planning to offer course on HLS using C or C++, how we are writing applications for the target hardware, and then using HLS, how we are converting, using this high level synthesis, how we are converting to RTL synthesis, and from there to gate level. Definitely, I will communicate because we are there in the group. So that way, I will update you people. So the currently, as I shown starting of this today's session, I shown some units. Total 8 units are there about this basic level course. So this fundamental course will do with this ISE alone. Why we are not going to Vivado at this stage, at this point, I think to everyone it is clear. So now, even before going to that ISE, let us have one more discussion. So one more discussion is, whatever that you write, whatever that you write here, suppose say half adder dot v. This is half adder code. So the extension of the any file will be dot v. So in this inside, you are writing anything that is related to your half adder. So this is called your design file. Your design file. And you write similar to this design file, another file. So that is test dot v. This name you can give anything. And this name you can give anything. So this is inside again, this is similar to design file only. Because everything you start in a Verilog module and then you end anything with a end module. So similarly, here also happens, you start module and end module. So inside again, whatever happens is you only give here, then we call test vectors. Test vectors are stimuli, are stimulus. So we give here that. This one also known as this one is also known as DUT, design under test, or sometimes CUT, component under test. That way also we call this one, this module. So this module needs to be instantiated here. This needs to be, there is a term called instantiated. We have to instantiate this one, instantiated. So we have to instantiate here this module. So and then we give some test vectors here inside this file, being in this test file. So how many files are there? One is design file, the other is a test file. What is that we are doing, guys? In the test file, we instantiate our DUT, design under test or component under test. This one we instantiate here. What is the term, guys, there? Those who are not familiar, that is instantiation or instantiated, that one, this one here. So these are the basic fundamentals that we have to have before dealing with this ISE. So now let us quickly go to that ISE here. As I said, this is one window you see here, design window, this one here. And this is the processes window. And here is a console window, any errors, any messages, them you will see here. And then here, this area, you see the tabs here. Now, currently only design summary tab is there. If there are several files, you see them here in this area. So now you go to first this one here, you see the hierarchy should be like this. Your project name and then the device and then your this one module name and then file name in the parentheses. So first project name, device and your module. So this one, let us start with a fresh one here. So we go to this file, you are going to the file. Guys, those who are not familiar, carefully listen, because you have to practice this one. Go to file, go to new project. And here you type your project name. So we type here WAND, WAND underscore test. So this is WAND underscore test I am typing. So guys, there, those who are not familiar, please pay attention carefully. And the location here, where I want this project to be, that one here I am setting. Otherwise, you can set here this three horizontal dots are there. You select this one and browse the, your location of choice. There you can keep this one. This is a working directory. Working directory is one, during your compilation, your simulation, several files will generate. Them if you want to separate, them you want to keep separately. So that is working directory. So that also you can select. But by default, what I'm doing here in this demonstration, in the same location, the project files also I'm keeping, And also I am going to keep work, that project file directory itself is working like a working directory. After that, this description is an industry practice. What for this application needs that here. And this top level source type should be HDL. If you drop, there is a drop down menu. If you pick this one here, you have schematic, you have EDIF, you have NGC, NGO. So a schematic entry, nowadays nobody will carry out, but this tool is still facilitating schematic entry, because as you know, schematic means we should be knowing how many gates are required, in which way they are connected. The very reason why we are switching to Verilog HDL or any HDLE, we really don't know the hardware required. We just know how hardware behaves. And that behavior we want to code it. That coded one is given to a software called synthesizer. That synthesizer will give us the hardware. So that's why there is no point of selecting this schematic. There is a called EDIF, Electronic Design Information Interchange Format. If you are migrating your design from Intel's Quartz tool to Xilinx ISE, then this is helpful. If you are migrating from Xilinx ISE to that Quartz, or from Quartz to this tool also, then this is helpful. So you have to get this one design into this Electronic Design Information Interchange Format. So from one tool to another tool, there are several differences. So at that time, anyway, straight go to this one here, HDL, ensure that HDL is there, go to next. Here I was talking about that Vivado. Vivado, I was telling Arctix, some tool, some hardware. So that is Arctix here, that Arctix. So low end your FPGAs are, you have low end, Smarton 6 is there. 6 is a low end compared to the Arctix 7, Kintec 7, lower end FPGA device, this is called. So how do we know for what applications this is more suitable? By going to that Xilinx website and going to this Smarton 6 manual. That's how we come to know for what application this is more suitable. So anyway, guys, that's how you select. I was talking about this one here, applications here, the product category. So my target application may be military application or radiation tolerant application or some general purpose, home, domestic purpose sort of. So likewise, depending upon that, this company fellow, this Xilinx vendors, will be developing FPGA hardware kits. So I know that Kintec, if I am using it, is for military application. Kintec 7, if I am using, it's a military application. So my final design is going on to the target device. So definitely at that time, those device properties I have to take into consideration. That's why I have to select military, this high reliability. And then related to this military high reliability, the family will be coming here. Defense grade Arctic 7. You see the defense, all defense you see here. Everybody able to see or not? Suresh, can you able to see this defense like that?
Yes, yes. Yeah.
Thank you. So that's how these products you select. But coming to our learner's point of view, since we are not targeting our current design to, neither we are targeting to military applications, nor we are targeting to automotive. Automotive means, suppose your car is a high-end car. This high-end car is having several sensors. So suppose, say, you are parking, reverse parking. So at that time, any obstacles are there. So all such sensors are mounted onto that your vehicle or any other automotive. Not only your car, any other automotive. So there were, so in that environment, what devices should be there. So for that, this product category is your automotive. So like that you can select, and related to that automotive, this company has developed some sort of FPGA, some this cool runner you see, that is a CPLD actually. It's a complex programmable CPLD logic device. So like that. So you have the Arctic 7 also. You have Arctic 7. That is high-end FPGA. So how do we know that this is a high-end application and this is a lower-end application and this is a medium-level application, this Zinc? So only thing is we have to go to the Zinc, that is Xilinx webpage. There the sections are categorized, nice PDFs are available. Then we have to refer. Then we will understand, array, this is for that application, like that we pick. But for this learning point of view, we simply don't touch either of this one. Simply default all we keep, and the family we go here. Family, if suppose I have with me Spartan 3E board, I thought of demonstrating you people using Spartan 3E kit, and which is available with me. So that in that case, I can go to that Spartan 3E. Otherwise, for simulation purpose alone, on system alone, you don't mind picking anyone here, because after all you just want to simulate and see. So that's how this choice is picked like that. And coming to this device, if I put Spartan 3, you see the various devices are coming in here, listed here. You see there is a 100E, 250E, 500E, likewise. Meaning is, this family has got different sub-devices in this family. Some is able to have 100,000 logic elements in that. Some is able to have 100,000, here 250,000, and here 500,000. So this is the ability. That suppose if I pick this one, meaning I have with me Spartan 3E, but the logic element that it supports 500,000 only. How do I know that my design can go up to 5,000 logic element? I don't know. I cannot predict. I'm roughly estimating that my 8086 processor will not exceed that. So at that time I fix them and I start working and I synthesize. Yes. During synthesis, tool will report saying that your design actually exceeding than what the target device you have chosen. Are you getting the point, guys, there? How I am making the choice here? So my design, this I write some code here, right? At this point, I write some code. So I perform synthesis. Having performed synthesis, it will generate some gate level netlist. It will tell that area, I mean consumed, that consumption, device sources consumption. At that time it reports saying that your actual design is exceeding much more than what the device you have picked up. Meaning definitely Spartan 3 is not suitable choice for me. So that's how you understand. So I will answer that, but it is better you unmute and ask, because I had to switch like this. I had to come to the chat window, I had to see. Because the sound has come, so I thought somebody trying to join. How to set speed grade? Yeah, I am coming to that. So one after another I am coming. So now what you see here is, you have the package with you. This package is, you know, that dual inline package, we have different package styles. Our ICs, integrated circuits, when they come into the market, depending upon the applications, like suppose I am going to send to the moon. Moon is a project by some our ISRO. ISRO is sending some tiny satellite to somewhere or something to the moon, wherein I thought of having some FPGA based design. So at that time, whether this package is suitable for that environment, something related to this package also, the detailed PDFs are available. So depending upon the application, these packages are also chosen. And depending upon the pin size also, the one package will have some pin count. The other package will have more number of pin count. The other pack, like pin count also depends upon the package. Package, environment, apart from that, pin numbers, how many pin numbers it can support. That information also is decided by this package. Now coming to the speed grade here, let me put here FG320 is a package. I have put the FG320. device, my device is 500E, my package is FG320, but the speed grid, if you see, I have two choices here in this case. One is -5, the other is -4. Meaning what? -5 is more faster than minus five is more faster than -4. So this I will tell with this example. This one. Let me go to this paint here. So what I am doing here is I am developing an AND gate. This is my AND gate, and this is also a AND gate. Another 1, 2, 3. Here all, this is having 1, 2, 3. And the output that I obtain here is, let us say, 1 nanosecond. The output that I obtain here is, let us say, it is 5 nanoseconds. After all, same AND gate, but the difference is, in the delay, you see this, there is a difference. Suppose there is a company called ABC. There is a company called XYZ. This ABC has fabricated this one. And this one has fabricated by XYZ. So that could be the reason why for a given technology, this is more advanced. Here what we use actually, inside this, after all, you have bunch of transistors, right? Your AND gate means Y equal to A, B. A, B means this is two pull-down transistors. This is NMOS here. These are NMOS. And dual of that you take here, A plus B. So two PMOS devices. Here two PMOS devices. And this is connected here, and one inverter is required because it is not inverted form. So in a CMOS, we need a one inverter. Other way also there are several other ways. This is one inverter. So like that we connect, and this is given to VDD. So what is there inside transistors, right? So these transistors actually, this transistor is actually having something like this physical appearance. If you see here, some source, some drain, and here you have length, gate length. This gate length is suppose a 180 nanometer for fabrication. 180 nanometer. ABC using 180 nanometer. And this is also using 180 nanometer. But still there is a difference here. That is the fabrication problem. There are a lot of physics involved here to discuss. But at this point, you only have to understand it's related to fabrication, these issues are. But the same company, ABC, may develop different gates. Like another with 0.5 nanosecond also, which is faster than earlier 1 nanosecond. So same company, same 180 nanometer technology is same again, 180 nanometer. This is fine tuned 0.5 delay, and this is not that fine delay. So those are fabrication related issues. This is another course. This itself is another course. Why these delays and all? It's the physical design course, what we call in a VLSI. Guys, there who are listening, you have to understand all this VLSI terminology. The physical PD, physical design. This is another course. RTL coding is different. So that is another course. Currently, what we are there in RTL coding course, physical design course. This also I can run, but I will communicate this one. In this physical course, we learn this, why these delays are like that. These transistors are causing actually. There are parasitics involved. How do we reduce these parasitics and all? There are a lot of physics here. So these physics, these are called library files. These are called library files. Who is providing this vendor? Fabrication fellow providing this library file. We use along with RTL in ASIC design, along with RTL, we also have to use this technology file and put together them and constraint file also. Constraints, we give constraints. What constraints, what library file, all this come in the physical design course. So this, in ASIC design also, it will come partly, front end. So now it will generate gate level netlist, this gate level netlist. These gates, depending upon the library we chosen, depending upon the constraints we given, depending upon the layout, during layout we reduce this parasitics and all. So depending upon that, these delays finally decided. These delays are finally decided that way. So that is what happening here. The device is same, family is same, device is same, package is also same, but we have two different speed grades. This is minus 5 is faster than that minus 4. So who has said this minus 5 is faster than minus 4? Again, the device, Xilinx company website. If you go to that Spartan 3, there you will understand this. The document, if you download, related document to this Spartan 3 and from Xilinx website. Then you have to set this this one, XST, Xilinx Synthesis Technology. Few people will say XST means Xilinx Synthesis Tool. But Xilinx, in its document, it is calling, it's a Xilinx Synthesis, not tool, it's a technology. So that is default, there is no other simulator. But the simulator is of our choice. There are several simulators here. This iSIM is a inbuilt simulator to Xilinx iSIM. And Model Sim is from Mentor Graphics, and Questa is also from Mentor Graphics. So these are third-party tools in my system. If I have installed them, then I can pick them, either one. If I don't have anything default iSIM, I can leave like that. So what is the advantage, disadvantage? That we'll see some other day, because we are exceeding time now. So the rest of the things default, leave like that, because a lot more things to discuss here, but running out of time, so I'm just leaving like that and click next. And then this is the summary you get, and then finish. And then, guys, here you see there is nothing here. But I said this hierarchy will be your project here, project name, and your design device, what the device that you have chosen. So them you see here in the hierarchy meter. So now this left hand side you see here, if you keep your if you hover your mouse cursor there, you see new source. From here you can click, you get this one, this sort of window, wizard, not window, this wizard you get. The other is you go to this project and click their new source, same wizard will come. The other is from here, right click and new source, the same wizard will come, guys. So there are three ways to obtain this one. Select Verilog HDL. Don't ever conclude new learner there. Verilog HDL, don't acronym for Verilog HDL, VHDL. You don't acronym from your side. VHDL is another language. Never ever acronym, shortcut of Verilog HDL, never conclude VHDL. VHDL in itself is another language. You will not be picking this one. You have to pick Verilog module. Having picked Verilog module, go to your file name here. The file name, if I am demonstrating my half adder, so I type HA. So here I type my HA and ensure that add to project here, check mark is there here. Here check mark should be there. By default, it will be there. You also ensure by mistake it hasn't removed, you ensure that it should be there. And then click on next. And these things you don't need to fill. If you fill, no issues with that. But most of the times you feel like later on typing your manually rather filling here. You can explore at home, because running out of time here. So I'm not going to take up this one. You can explore at home. If you have doubts, the other day you can ask. On WhatsApp you can ask. So clicking next and then finish. So now you see here at this stage, you have the tabs here. See ha.p. the file that you have created, and design summary tab that you have automatically has come when this file has been created. In this, you see here the synthesis report, nothing here, blank here. Translation report, blank. Map report, blank. All are blank here. As you go along with this, implementation here, this synthesis, if you expand, you see a lot more things here. If you expand this implement design, you see here translate, map, place and route. So all these activities are there. So the moment you keep proceeding that way, so this will be seen here in this range. So now what I had to do is, I had to first very quickly I had to write this A comma B comma sum comma C O. So that is my Verilog code. This is my module. This is my module end module. Guys, they're new learners. This tool has generated default template. This template is based on the file name what I gave. This it has chosen module name here. So let me try to zoom this one. F8. If I press F8, I should be able to zoom. New learners there, please focus this one. This is the tool generated here. What it has generated, line one, backport time scale 1 nanosecond/1 ps. I will take up tomorrow what this means, because just running out of time. This is company, engineer name, all that you have to fill. It's a company standards, people follow like that, but since we are learners, we are just removing this one. And then end module tool, any Verilog code will start with a module and end with the end module. And this HA is a user defined. This template, this tool has generated automatically this. So based on the file name you gave, so it has taken this name. So this is a user defined, you can give any name. Inside this is called port list. The port, my half adder may have AB inputs, sum and carry out output, that's it. That's why the port in this, this is called port list area. So I have to list my primary inputs and primary outputs. Remember, primary inputs and primary outputs. I will talk about what is meant by primary input and primary output later on in case of any problem. So I use this keyword input, A comma B, and the semicolon, and then output, and then sum comma CO, and then I will be using here for demonstration purpose, data flow level modeling, assign, and then here I use concatenation operator. This is to concatenate, and CO I am writing first, and then sum, and here I will be using A plus operator. I am using, these are the operators I am using. So just to wrap the session ugly, I'm doing all this rushing that way. So you please feel free to ask doubts on WhatsApp here. So I have done with my code now. So before this synthesizing this one, why I need to synthesize? So that I can get the hardware of what this application. What is the application? It's a half adder. So this could be 8086 processor also here, the code will be. So, but in this example, for demonstration purpose, we have taken this. But how do I know that this description itself is correct? So for that, I had to write a test bench. For that, again, I have to go here, new source. Previous, I demonstrated one is here, the other is project, the other is right click, like that also you can get. This time, this Verilog test fixture. Guys, new guys there, pay attention, Verilog test fixture. And the file name is of your choice. I will be giving here test, and then ensure that this is checked, and next. If you are 8086, here you are developing 8086, there are several submodules will come. Those submodules are listed here. Since in our case, only one module is there, only one module is highlighted. So with which I want to associate my test file. So that's why this one is default is there. If there are several other here, you can select to which module you want to associate that test bench. So next, and then finish. So this will generate here a template again. You see the HA and design command, and this test also has come. Guys, the new guys here, very quickly just to wrap here, template it has generated. I will take up in subsequent classes. Just I want to demonstrate the simulation. So rushing here very quickly. So I write here for loop for what I want to put here is I equal to 0, and then I less than or equal to 3, and then I equal to I plus 1. So them everything, these things I am just removing. I'm just putting my way of inputs to the code. So then begin, and then I am putting here this concatenation operator I am using. To A and B, I am just giving this I. I'm just giving this I, and then semicolon, and then after delay of 5, again another assignment will happen. Don't bother about this one. If you are not understanding at this stage, anyone there is not understanding, don't bother. Just because I just want to demonstrate how to simulate. And the document PDF WAND WAR, them you try at home with this way of tool how to use. I'm demonstrating how to use. So just you have to copy and paste, because in the shared document PDF WAND and WAR already codes are there. Test bench code is there, and design code also is there. So that's why just paste and simulate. So this I wrote, but here I have to initialize, because I did not declare the I here. It will throw error. So integer, you learned that the integer, right? Integer is of which data type? The variable data type. So I am just saving now. I am coming to this. You see the guys there here. You see the tabs here. You see tabs here. Implementation tab and the simulation tab. You come to the simulation, select this test, and go to this iSim simulator, and run this behavioral simulation. So I just my Avast antivirus for a while I stopped, because it is stopping that one. Disable for 10 minutes. So I'm just disabling that Avast. And then running this one. So run. So now what happens here? Guys, there you see this one here. You just have to click here at this anywhere. You see this one here, zoom to full view. To click that one, you see your values here. Just place cursor there and zoom. And here you see here several things to do here, but at this point, just I'm wrapping my session very quickly. You have your A, B values. You can drag this one cursor anywhere, and you can place just like that. Corresponding to the cursor where you left,